All right, let's discuss the Batman films. Let's discuss my opinions on it. I feel like most of you guys are going to get mad at me because of what I say about these films. You know, everyone has their own opinions. You know, I respect your opinion if you like these films, but everyone has their own opinion, you know. You can discuss your opinion down the bottom below and say what your thoughts on these films. But right now, we're going to talk about what I say, what my opinions are. So, yeah, the Tim Burton films, like... I cannot get into those films. It's too goofy and silly for me. I don't like Tim Burton's imagination, his vision. I don't really like it, the way he's written these characters and whatnot. I feel like Batman 1966 did a better job with a goofy and campiness. They did a better job with it. His ideas does not work, in my opinion. They don't do not work. Michael Caine does a good job. Jack Nicholson does a good job. I like Kim Basinger. She's hot. But the story is just written pretty poorly, not well written. I didn't like the story at all. It's just not for me. I mean, I liked some of the action scenes in there, especially the 1989 Batman. I liked the action scenes in there. Batman Returns, Danny DeVito. As Penguin, it's just not really. I wasn't really crazy about him as Penguin that much. Michelle Pfeiffer was hot. I love her as a Catwoman. She's still my favorite Catwoman. I'm not really crazy about that movie that much. Yeah, Michael Keaton didn't want to do it no more, so he got replaced by Val Kilmer in Batman Returns. Not Batman Returns. Batman Forever. And this is with... it's when he gets Robin, played by... I forgot what his fucking name was. Something Christopher. He plays Robin. He does a good job playing Robin. And you got fucking Jim Carrey as Riddler. I didn't mind him as Riddler. It's just that the way he wore that spandex stuff is kind of a little too ridiculous. Two-Face. Tommy Lee Jones does a great job as Two-Face. You know, those two didn't get along with each other, and they talk shit to each other. And Joel Schumacher had to break them up most of the time. And I like Joel Schumacher, but this movie's all right. He wrote fine for this movie, but the sequel... Batman Robin, that was terrible. I'm sorry, that was bad. That was awful. You know, Arnold Schwarzenegger did a good job. I love Uma Thurman. She was pretty hot in there. She did fine. Bane is made into a retard in that fucking movie. He's a fucking musclehead idiot. I wish he should have been like the way he was in The Dark Knight Rises, but whatever. They made goofy campiness again, which they did with Batman Forever. But Batman Forever was tolerable. I could handle the goofiness in that movie. And they cut a lot of shit out in that movie in general. Because I heard that there's a lot of stuff they took out of the Batman Forever. It was a lot more darker than it was supposed to be. Batman Forever was supposed to be a lot darker. And that wasn't that goofy like that. Because, you know, Joel Schumacher wrote Falling Down. He directed and wrote it. And that was a beast movie. And it was a pretty badass film. And I think he was trying to write Batman Forever into Falling Down film, but the fucking Warner Brothers be a bunch of clowns, and they're like, no, don't do that. Make it for little kids. So that's what happened. Fucking bullshit. So Batman Forever was supposed to be a lot darker. I don't know, it was supposed to be like The Dark Knight or whatever, but it was a lot darker. It's a shame how Warner Brothers got to ruin everything. In other words, like I said, Batman Robin, that shit was stupid as fuck. That's even... They're trying to be too much like Batman 1966, but... Nobody can be like Batman 1966. Nobody can be like that. Adam West is my favorite Batman. Don't get me wrong. He's my number one favorite Batman. I enjoyed the 66 version of Batman the most out of all the Batmans. Especially the show. That show kicks ass. I like that show. I don't care how campy it is, you know. It's fun. It's fun and exciting. You know, all that bam, wop, bop, all that shit popping in your fucking face. I'm like, holy shit, this shit's fucking awesome. I just bust the shit out of these motherfuckers. You know, I enjoy that the most. Then after all those fucking, those Tim Burton Schumacher films, like 8 years later, here comes Nolan's films. Oh god, this overrated director. The thing is, I don't like this guy. Especially his fucking overrated films like Inception. He copied off fucking Matrix. He ripped off Matrix and turned it his own fucking thing. I didn't like that film and his other films I didn't really like. Especially that one that came out in 2020 with Robert Pattinson. That one was terrible. That shit was stupid as fuck. Christopher Nolan's an overrated director. So his Batman films, he made three of them. One was Batman Begins. That was just... it was slow as hell. I didn't like it that much. I mean, I like Ra's al Ghul. You know, Liam Neeson's like one of my favorite actors. He does a good job. Christian Bale, I'm not really crazy about... I mean, Christian Bale's not bad. It's just that the voice he does as Batman is, like, too much. Like, I guess I got a throat full of dicks or something in his throat or something. I'm like, what the fuck's he doing? The thing with Scarecrow, I mean, I didn't mind Scarecrow, just that I don't think he ever actually gets Scarecrow. I don't remember he actually, you know, gets him, like, arrested or anything like that. Because, like, second and third movie, he's walking around and doing stuff again. Like, he's, like, he's out of jail and shit. I think he does get arrested, but he's, like, out of jail again, and that's it. I was like, what was the point of that? He doesn't really do anything anymore, either. He just walks around and does normal shit. Like, what the fuck? Then a Dark Knight came, and that shit kicked ass, because Heath Ledger, he does a really good job in that film. Sad what happened to him. You know, I'm not a master, I'm just ahead of the curve. I love his line in that. You know? Like, what the... Like, still, like... The action scenes, like, he sucks at action scenes, Christopher Nolan. Like, every time he does a final fight with these main villains... Joker versus Batman was terrible. The final fight between those two, it wasn't that good. Then you had the fucking Batman versus Bane, and the final fight with that was terrible. And like, I don't know what the fuck they were doing with that shit. Just, he sucks at final fights. Should've been like way more awesome than that. Dark Knight Rises, it's an alright movie. It's just that I'm not really crazy about it. Most of the time I just watch it because of Bane. I only watch it because of everyone else. Fucking, the Catwoman is like the worst part of the movie. She like, Anne Hathaway is like the worst choice for Catwoman. Like, out of all the hot chicks you go with, you went with Anne Hathaway. She's not even attractive. Well, what does Christopher Nolan see in that woman? What does he find attractive about her? I don't get it. So many women you choose from. You go with Anne fucking Hathaway, that broad. She's not even attractive. She's like a baseless baked chicken. Whatever, I don't get this guy. He's still like a hack to me. Like, the only film I liked from him was the Dark Knight. Dark Knight Rises is okay. The first one film was slow as fuck. I mean, the chicks are hot in those movies. Marion Cotillard, Maggie Gyllenhaal, the other Rachel from the first movie. Those are pretty hot chicks. But yeah, fucking Christopher Nolan. Then you got Ben Affleck. Thing is, it's not his fault that the movies are written terrible. It's just that the shitty directors, more hacks like Zack Snyder and Josh Wiener, they don't know what the fuck they were doing. Like, I like his suit. I like his suit, Ben Affleck. I love the way his suit looks, but the way they've written him is just terrible. And it's a shame he never got his own Batman film, because he would have been pretty good if they had the right director and writer. Like, if they got the guy who did The Accountant and wrote The Accountant and did the Batman film with Ben Affleck, it would have been really, really good, I'm telling you. Yeah, the same guy who did The Accountant would have been really good, I'm telling you. And the fucking, Justice League and Batman vs. Superman, that shit was terrible. Like, how do you fuck up Batman vs. Superman? How do you fuck it up? That shit should have been awesome. Like, what the fuck are they doing? And that shit should have been like a non-canon film or something like that. It should have been like Batman kills Superman and Batman wins or something like that. That would have been awesome. He kills him with kryptonite, like stabs him in his head, like that. But you can't have rated R films, so you can't do that. Justice League, like 4-hour long movie. Who the fuck's gonna sit there and watch that whole fucking thing? Well, these stupid fucking story they had for it. And all these people love it. I don't get why. All these disgusting, sweaty nerds. Fucking sucking Zack Snyder's dick, you know, that guy's like an overrated hack. I don't get what's so good about Zack Snyder, especially he made that shitty fucking zombie movie that came out last year, or the other year, I forgot what year it came out, it was terrible too. Like, what the fuck, why do you like this guy so much? He's a hack, just like J.J. Abrams and Rian Johnson when they made those Star Trek and Star Wars movies. I don't get what's so good about these directors, they're hacks. They don't care about us, they care about the money. Well, the most directors like that, but still, they suck. They don't, they have shitty fucking imagination. Fuck these Batman movies made by Zack Snyder and Josh Wiener. They terrible. Ugh. Holy moly. But now we got Matt Reeves Batman, and he did a good job at it. I mean, this guy is smart. I can see what he's going to do with the other films. This guy's pretty smart at it. I didn't mind Robert Pattinson as Batman. He's not a bad Batman. I don't mind him. Zoe Kravitz, I think she did a good job. She was pretty attractive. Penguin is the highlight. Colin Farrell is the highlight of the film. I really enjoyed him as Penguin with Robert De Niro face. I really enjoyed him. I like John Turturro as Falcone. He's the best Falcone. Nolan's Falcone sucks ass. Fucking, what else? Oh yeah, Jeffrey Wright as Commissioner Gordon did a good job. Before I was like, I don't know, I trust this guy, but then I watched it again. I was like, oh yeah, he does a good job. I mean, not watch it again, but I watched the movie. I was like, all right, he does a good job. I'll probably watch the movie a second time and give it another try. The Batman film came out this year. I'm gonna give it another try so I can get into it again. No, I mean try to get into it, because the first time I watched it, I was like, it was decent. But I'm gonna try again in the future. Riddler, I didn't mind the Riddler. Paul Dano, I didn't mind him. He did a good job. I didn't mind him. But I don't know. He's like good like Jim Carrey. I mean, he's you know, he's good as Jim Carrey, but he's not. I don't know. I can put above Jim Carrey. But they both did good. I like his outfit, Paul Dano, more than Jim Carrey's outfit. Jim Carrey is like I said, I'm not into the goofy stuff they had in those Batman films. I'm not into that really that silliness stuff. Well, I like more of the serious stuff, like The Dark Knight, the Batman 2022. I like a more realistic, serious tone more than anything. You know, I like the Adam West Batman, though. Well, yeah, like, because, you know, at the end of the Batman film this year, the 2022 Batman, it had a scene where Joker's in the prison talking to Riddler. I'm like, oh, great, again, a joke for the millionth time. The thing is, here's the idea. Maybe if Joker can hire, like, Deadshot and Deathstroke to work with him to take out Batman. Now, that would be a great fucking movie. And Matt Reeves is that smart. He should make Joker hire those two, you know, to help him out take out Batman. That shit would have been awesome. Or Mr. Freeze would have been a better character instead of Joker. Mr. Freeze deserved to be in another movie again. It sucks we don't see him anymore since 1997. Like, what the fuck? I want Mr. Freeze. Why is there a fucking Joker all the time? But that'd be a great idea. Joker hires Deadshot and Deathstroke to take out Batman. That should be awesome. But I don't know. Y'all know that guy's that smart, Matt Reeves. Maybe he is. Who knows? We'll see in the future. But anyways, yeah. Yeah, it's just... These movies, it's just... I'm not really crazy about live action films that much. Like the cartoons, like Batman Beyond and fucking the Batman 2004 cartoon, or I never watched Brave and the Bold. I want to, well, I never got a chance to. CGI Batman, I never watched that one. That's 2014 one. Batman the Animated Series, I never watched it. I think I watched like some parts of it, but I never watched the whole thing. I never actually watched the whole show. So I think I was like too young or something. I forgot. Maybe one day I'll watch that show. I don't know right now though. But anyways, yeah. Live action films, yeah. Like I said, 1989 Batman, I can't get into it. It's too goofy. Same with Batman Returns. Fucking... Batman Forever is tolerable. You know, that has too goofy shit in there, too. Batman for Robin is awful. But Arnold Schwarzenegger and Uma Thurman did good. I didn't mind George Clooney as Batman. Yeah... I guess Batgirl was alright. And Robin, he did fine still. Oh yeah, Joseph Gordon-Levitt as the cop. People keep calling him Robin, but he's not Robin. He's just a regular cop. But we could see him as Robin, though. But my favorite Batman will always be Adam fucking West. He was always be my favorite Batman out of all of them. Yeah, I like... Robert Pattinson, I like Christian Bale, you know, he had that annoying voice.
I like Michael Keaton. You know, I'm not a fan of the movies. I didn't mind Val Kilmer and George Clooney. I didn't mind Ben Affleck. You know, he had shitty writing all around him because of hack directors.
But yeah, that Adam West will always be my favorite. None of can replace him. Right? Especially the TV show and the movie. That shit kicks ass. Bam, wop, sop, wow, wow. All that shit. Come on, man. That shit's, it's just classic. I still gotta buy that show, man. It's just funny. It's just funny and awesome. My trusty psychic. Yeah, he's my favorite Batman, man. Nothing can replace him. Rob Pattinson can't replace him, or Christian Bale, or fucking Michael Keaton. They can't beat him. In my opinion, they can't beat him. Yeah, he's my favorite. I said my favorite Joker is Heath Ledger. My favorite Penguin is Colin Farrell. My favorite Catwoman, Michelle Pfeiffer. Uma Thurman. I mean, she's the only one that's actually played Poison Ivy. No one else played Poison Ivy yet, but I can say she's my favorite. I like Mr. Freeze. Arnold Schwarzenegger. Let's see. What else I'm missing here? My favorite commissioner is still gonna be a guy from The Dark Knight. I just said his name. But he's my favorite. But yeah. Fuck. Yeah, it's like I said, I'm not really crazy about the live action films like that, but I can say like number one could be The Dark Knight, number two would be The Batman 2022, maybe number three could be Batman 1966 movie. I can say that. But yeah. That's my top three. Dark Knight, Batman 2022, and Batman 1966 with Adam West. I don't know. Maybe one day I'll get back. I'll try watching 1989 Batman Returns again. I'll get another try. But right now, I tried watching that before, like a couple of weeks ago. I couldn't get into it. 1989. I'll try to get one another time, but I'm not so sure about fucking Ben Affleck shit. That shit's too fucking long for me. Especially that Batman versus Superman crap. That shit was terrible. Like, what the fuck were they thinking? Oh, I'm sorry. Zack Snyder, the hack. I forgot about that guy. That guy can't even direct traffic more than fucking write a goddamn movie. That's how stupid that guy is. Like, fuck. Especially Cyborg. He sucked ass in that movie. Like, he's like too skinny. He's supposed to be buff as shit. Like, in the cartoon, I remember he's like buff. But in the like, live action, like, he's like, why is he so skinny? Didn't he start with, was he like buff or something? Like, what the fuck is this shit? That's not Cyborg. I mean, Cyborg is like, that dude didn't put on some fucking weight or something. Eat something, dude.
Work out.
Like, he's like skinny, dude. Like, I don't know why that black dude's so skinny. But eat something. Get game. Work out. Get muscles. Yeah, fuck Batman vs. Superman. Fuck the Justice League crap. Garbage dookie movies. I don't know what the fuck they're thinking. I'm gonna stick with fucking Batman 2022 and The Dark Knight and Adam West movies. That's all I'm gonna stick with. Adam West show. That's all I'm gonna stick with. Fuck that other live action shit. Like I said, Batman Forever is tolerable. I don't mind
Batman Forever.
Dark Knight Rises is all right. The reason why I say it's all right is because of Bane. I love Bane in that movie. He kicks ass. Like, he's my favorite Bane. Like, there's no way my Bane could beat Tom Hardy's Bane. Fuck it. I hate those other Jokers, though. Fucking Jared Leto. He's like the worst Joker ever. Like, what the fuck are they thinking? He's like a fucking, I don't know, stupid, however we call it, but he's terrible, though. He's the worst Joker. Fuck, he looks stupid as hell. He looks retarded. He like Pete Davidson or something. That's how bad he looked. But anyways, yeah. Fuck. My favorite Batman is Adam West. It would be Adam West. You know, like, fuck those other guys. It's funny that you don't see Vicki Vale anymore in Batman films anymore. Like, after 1989 Batman, you don't see Vicki Vale anymore. Then what the fuck happened to Vicki Vale? Like, you don't even see that lady anymore. At a Kim Basinger, you don't see Vicki Vale anymore. Like, what the fuck is, where's Vicki Vale? Where's that photographer lady? Or news reporter? What the fuck happened to her? She's like, you don't see no more in live action films. After 1989, she's not there no more. Now there's all these other bras, Catwoman, Poison Ivy. You know Poison Ivy's a bad guy, and Catwoman's a thief. You know she's a bad guy. But yeah, you don't see like Vicky Vale anymore. You got like other chicks now. Like the Nolan films, yeah, like Rachel. And she got killed, and he had some other chick, and she got killed. And yeah, it's like. You don't see Vicky Vale anymore. She got, like, replaced by these other broads.